Hello and welcome back to Tesla News. My name is Marian and I'm your host today, covering today the big EV price battle that has just started, and we will look into that and how Tesla is positioned itself in this situation. And if you do enjoy that, do consider subscribing to my channel, and we will start talking about Ford and VW in this case as well, because those EV makers, or starting to be EV makers in this case, we'll try to compete with Tesla, and I'm really saying try it. We will see if that is playing out. Looking at Giga Berlin here, we do see the ground here being made, and we do see it's really complicated construction happening here. So it really supports the idea it is later going to be the battery cell production and not only a storage hall. And when we look at Giga Berlin, there is the major reason that is being worked on right now, that we are talking about batteries. And the battery cell production will be the key for Tesla to succeed in the near future. And Tesla is currently leading when it comes to the price per kilowatt hour. And this is also the key when we talk about the Ford pickup that was just announced and presented. Got a lot of publicity, a lot of marketing happened here, and Joe Biden was driving it, etc., etc. But at the end of the day, investors that are investing in stocks or public figures that are analyzing the numbers of a company will always look at the profitability, and they will look at how a company like Ford or Tesla will achieve profitability in the future despite the increasing competition in the market. So when we talk about competition, we have to I have to clarify here that I don't mean that Ford is going to beat Tesla here. Goldman Sachs says that they are targeting under $100 per kilowatt hours by mid-decade. But on the other hand, they say Tesla is already there and will be at around $60. So those $60 can only be achieved if all the announcement at Battery Day 2020 are actually being done. And we do know that Tesla is working on these new battery cells. And this is the key, guys. If Tesla is achieving to put the new battery cells into the Model Y and maybe at some stage as well into the Model 3, and talking about the Cybertruck inside the Cybertruck this year, then Tesla is unbeatable. Because they will achieve price reductions, or they could achieve price reductions if they wanted to, that no one else can. On the other hand, Tesla has right now a lot of reservations. We do know that they have no chance or no reason to reduce prices on the Cybertruck or the Model Y. So what is happening here? Tesla will be much more profitable. They will be able to make much more money. And they can invest it into new factories, in better technology, and even getting better. And this is the key here. When we talk about Ford, Ford is entering now the market at a level that Tesla is right now, and they are trying to be there in 2 to 3 years. So Tesla will be in 2025 already achieving much more profitability on their cars. When we talk about $100 per kilowatt hour, we still have Tesla not printing money right now. They will be doing that at some point, but we won't see that right now. And we do know that there are a lot of critics out there saying, well, Tesla is just owning with the credits. But again, if you imagine that is happening right now with the price of around $100 per kilowatt hour, what is Ford gonna do? I mean, this is the point here. And it's the same thing for VW. Both companies will have the issue to make really good money right now with the investment, with the amount of money that is needed per battery. And when we talk and look at the Cybertruck here, that is the key here. Just imagine you have a price, and in the marketing you say, well, it's going to be at the same price level. The Ford is looking good. Yes, customers will like that they have a pickup truck that is at the same price as the Cybertruck. But is it going to be the same range? Is it going to be the same quality? And is Ford actually going to make money with that? That's the key question here, which investors in Ford will ask. And yes, the stock price has increased in recent months again since Ford decided to go into the EV sector. But are they going to make money with that? That's the key question here. And this is what needs to be asked. And if Tesla is achieving lower prices like $60 per kilowatt hour, then Tesla has the chance to even further reduce prices if they wanted to, but they don't need to because people will buy the Cybertruck. But even though if Tesla has to do it, they could do it and still make more money with it as they are doing right now with their battery pack. So you see that the other car companies are maybe moving towards EV, moving towards a price of $100. But Tesla is not standing still. They are also moving forward. And that's the same when you look at the Model S, when you look at the Model X. Yes, the competition build new luxury cars. And we do see that here. Elon said that it's going to take another week. And a lot of people are joking about it. Well, it doesn't matter, guys. If it takes another week, it takes another week. But at the end of the day, they will deliver a perfect product out there. They will deliver a perfect luxury Model S and Model X. And that is the key here, guys, because we know Tesla has not updated the Model S for a long time. And they are doing right now. And they're bringing pretty much a new car, a much better car out to the market. And yes, there are other luxury car makers out there that have a pretty good product. But now Tesla is saying, well, if you try to catch up, we're gonna update, we're gonna get better, and they are gonna get better. And this is the key here. Tesla is always going a step further once other car companies are trying to catch up. And another factor you have not to forget is that Ford, for example, has a lot of debt. VW is investing a lot of money right now, and this is something you shouldn't forget. Tesla has debt, but they are not increasing their debt right now, and they are still trying to make more money. So looking at Giga Berlin, we will see how Tesla will change the entire European market here. They will go into the market share in Europe, and I don't really care about the market share right now because it will change anyways till the end of the year or latest beginning of next year once Tesla is really hitting the Model Y to the road in European continent. So going back to this price competition, we will see a lot of people compete, a lot of companies compete in the EV sector, but the key is not only the battery price, it is also the production, how efficient you can produce, robots that you install, so you have less costs to, and you have more income streams, because Tesla is not only making money with cars, they're also making money with the energy business at some point, and they have more income streams than any car maker out there, because Tesla is not a car maker, guys. So I hope you did enjoy my video, and I hope you have a wonderful day, and take care, guys. Thank you very much.